chaired the PAC. The APC now is chairing the PAC. So if it is anything, we have equalized the score. It is now only this constitutional review that will not take the bull by the horn. So now make sure that those things that are correct and should be done in a modern democracy system by ensuring that those committees that should be headed by the opposition will be headed, especially those transparency and accountability committees. I will not sit down without also making reference to 27.4 D&E. That relates to discrimination. Nobody should be discriminated against. But then, that clause also makes an exception. This exception has been one of the reasons why the country has not brought along their other better half, the women of this country. So as this constitutional review is going on, we make sure that this constitution is inclusive. This constitution creates room for everybody, men and women, to use their talents and their God-given talents to be executed. No longer should we in Sierra Leone, after this constitution, people be judged by their gender. They should be judged by their capability, by their talent, by what they can do, and not by who they are. Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, let me say that we are watching, and we as parliamentarians, we also do whatever we can to ensure that this constitutional review process befits Sierra Leone. Sierra Leone, we are good at making history. We make history by being a country who, after 11 years, stop the war. Today, Sierra Leone is one of the safest countries. We can travel at night with very little fear that we'll be apprehended by peace. We have set history by ensuring that in two consecutive elections, we have had peaceful handing over. I'm sure we also set history by ensuring that this constitution, at the end of the day, will be our constitution. A constitution that will take Sierra Leone from where we are now to where we want to be. I thank you and I acknowledge the Constitutional Committee to do their work with the best of intentions, not being persuaded by any political party or by any faction, but by one and only one, being Sierra Leone and Sierra Leoneans only. I thank you and I wish them good luck.
Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Sierra Leone, Honourable Vice President of the Republic of Sierra Leone, Ali Chief Justice, Honourable Ministers of the Government, Members of Parliament, Political Party Representatives, Traditional Authorities, Civil Society Representatives, Members of the Diplomatic and Consular Corps, the Chairperson, Members of the Constitutional Review Committee, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure and an honor for me to take part on behalf of the United Nations in this historic occasion of the official launch of the review of the Constitution of the Republic of Sierra Leone. The review of the Constitution, although long awaited, as an important provision of the Lomé Peace Agreement of 7 July 1999 and the key recommendation of the Sierra Leone Truth and Reconciliation Commission, comes at an opportune moment in the country's transformation from a post-conflict to a development phase, with remarkable achievements to build on and important new challenges to tackle. The United Nations welcomes the political commitment and leadership demonstrated by the government of Sierra Leone, in particular, His Excellency the President, to an initiative and to an inclusive and transparent constitutional review process. Likewise, we would like to acknowledge the efforts made by the previous government to launch a review exercise back in 2007. That would make the Constitutional Review to be formally launched this morning, a national enterprise that will build on the work that has been done so far, and at the same time reflecting the current realities as well as the prospects for further progress. We are also pleased that the review process, from its very start, is led and owned by the government and people and national institutions of Sierra Leone. This is amply demonstrated in the composition of the Constitutional Review Committee. Therefore, the role of the United Nations and the rest of the international community will be to support the process to achieve its intended objectives in a participatory and transparent manner. Accordingly, a joint program document has been signed some 2 weeks ago between the government of Sierra Leone and the United Nations. The program outlines the key activities to be undertaken and the funding required for the review process, as presented by the Honourable Minister of Justice and Attorney General. The United Nations and Sierra Leone Development Partners, and particularly the United Kingdom Department for International Development and the European Union, will make generous financial contributions in support of the review process. Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, it is true that constitutions are not ordinarily reviewed and only done at important moments in the life of a country. And this is one such moment for Sierra Leone. A constitution in any country is ultimately a compact which all citizens are bound together in service and dedication to their country. Every constitution defines the overarching goals and norms that determine and guide the aspirations and the future of a people, how they intend to live together, the values they see as unifying them. A constitution belongs and applies equally to all citizens of a nation. As such, this constitutional review represents an opportunity for strengthening Sierra Leone's democratic institutions, anchoring the rule of law and human rights, modernizing governance structures, promoting equitable economic development and social justice, and as a result of all these, fostering greater cohesion and unity amongst Sierra Leoneans. Sierra Leone's political parties, in particular, have a solemn opportunity and a duty through this process to reflect on the greater good of the nation and the bonds amongst them, their shared values, and how they can work together in a democratic political system for the advancement of their country. In essence, the review process will allow Sierra Leoneans of all shades of opinion to speak to each other in a spirit of togetherness on the direction their country should take in the 21st century and beyond. The composition of the Constitutional Review Committee with very broad representation is a proper starting point and a mechanism to ensure that the voices of all Sierra Leoneans are heard in this vital process. And we are confident that the committee will look very carefully on how the views of the citizenry are affected and effectively brought into the process. Indeed, a fully inclusive and transparent process underpinned by the participation of well-informed citizenry, knowledgeable about the matters that are subject of the review, and able to put forward their views, aspirations, and anxieties, will be the basis for a successful constitutional review process. This, in turn, will lead to a constitution which is owned and cherished by the Sierra Leoneans, and which the country and succeeding generations can be proud of. The Constitutional Review Committee has enormous responsibilities in this exercise, and there will be significant work ahead, including a possible referendum. Nonetheless, I'm optimistic that the review process will be a success, once again putting Sierra Leone in the forefront of progress and as a nation of hope and brighter future. Finally, Mr. Chairman, I wish to conclude with assurances of continued support of the United Nations and the international community in the constitutional review process, and by wishing the government and the people of Sierra Leone every success in this historic and national event. Thank you very much.
Free from players, say we don't ready.
Free from players, say we don't ready. Free from players, say we don't ready. Papa, don't talk and say we don't ready.
Charles Taylor, say he
no man.
Charles Taylor, say he don't know. Charles Taylor, say he don't know. But we, the people, say he won't know.
My brother, what's up with you now?
Children of tomorrow,
yes.
The old stars that they are not to be same thing.
Oh yeah,
I remember Balo Butenda,
Solomon
Samba, Kamadumbuya, Bate David, Silvanus Morris,
Enboy
Johnson, penalty expert, penalty shooter, penalty specialist, Oboy Johnson, Oboy Johnson. Not only Saint
Grandma
Atuga, may you rest in peace.
We
are listening. You ain't gonna quit me.
Waiting
you tell them. But Leo Stas, waiting you tell you. But Leo Stas, Tadea, not only Saint
Tigena, so Atuga,
slap our waiting the apple.
He's
the lion, mighty black bull. Oh, that dog, yes. FC Baron, FC Juansi,
waiting
the apple. Waiting the apple. Fans are waiting, Titans, baby.
Go!
His Excellency the President, Vice President, members of the High Table, all protocols of that. We are the Free Talk Players once more, and we are always happy to be part of development, and we hope everybody will be part of this development. Paul Mama Salome, we'll give you the short skit that we have on this program. Thank you.
Mamadou!
Now, Master!
Mamadou!
Now, Master!
You don't want to speak up?
I don't want to speak up now.
You don't want to speak up?
Yes, Master.
Alright, make sure to when you want to speak up, not open the boots, not get speak up at you.
Okay, Master.
What do you say?
You say open the boot, S the carpet.
I say not open the boot, not S the carpet. What did I say?
You say not open the boot, S the carpet.
Not that mercy, I'll tell you with this country. I'll tell you, honey.
Yes, darling.
I just left Mama.
The constitution
and yes.
All right. Now almost people then.
And the 80 man, now even at the committee.
Okay.
To everybody from different sides follow all system and make sure say the constitution.
All right, they go not let you know the lady.
Yes.
They go.
And
okay.
Only must meet me there.
You don't say Ali Kandi.
I love you.
Okay, take care.
Yeah.
And what did Mama do say? I don't wonder if you don't finish with your car.
Come.
Yes, come in. Hello, good morning.
Good morning, ma.
Yes, mommy, yeah, come on, ma.
Wait. This constitution of what is so that
way.
APC no more. Let me want to.
No. Not so for APC no more. This is the beyond party business. SLPP dede, APC dede, PNDC dede, UDA dede, all man dey inside it.
All man business.
Yes, all man business.
Mami Kawa, we na the judiciary na even wanna. This no, this country be no way serve up. Where they get that? Why you go inside the court? You lost. If you no way serve up, if you no way money, you can't smell the past. That I dey move. I dey put a leg.
All right, not for me, get for right now. Now the committee here for looking to her.
Knock.
All right.
We don't know.
All right.
Pass the message on to her.
Knock.
At the top of the scene. All
right. Knock.
Yes, hello, come in.
Mami Kawan.
Yes.
How are you? Yeah, Kawan.
No, I'm not my asshole.
Hey, Mami Kawan.
Yeah, come in.
Mami Kawan, good morning.
Yeah, good morning. Now the morning.
Mami Kawan, waiting with me, can I have?
Yes.
I don't want to come for Kandilu.
Yes.
Do ya this constitutional review where they go pa?
Yes.
You understand? Because I say na pakawa na ina di chairman. By the 80 man committee. You know so?
Yes.
But do ya this, I want let them put a name.
Yes.
What the fool let them put on a hand in the other day? This country for Tom Federal State. Yes. Let it Tom Federal State. So that Bo, Kenema, McKinney, Conor, they all go get the young post the way they govern them. Don't the problem will be the head.
All right.
Watch the announcers, he say, problem no dey. So anybody make mistake, pull up.
All right, I'll tell you, but I'm looking for that.
And now they have another name too. This national unity.
Yes.
It's very important.
It's very, very
important. The ballistic business, we for pull up come up and stick.
It's very, very important. Now one issue that one way they're looking to. National unity and coalition.
Now put a name.
Yes,
ma'am.
I can't say.
Yes,
ma'am. Why are you for this constitution and it makes so?
Yes.
I see. The thing I want to know, if we don't let small fund and they for put a paper for now for the total.
No.
That one day they know they put on there, and you know they inside they say Bappe for come back the third time.
Yes, our which at the top, you see me, I don't work 43 years na salary.
Yes.
I don't work, I don't serve government. Which I want, let them make organize, let them make the constitution provision for we go don't work. So after work, we go get condition, we go fine. We go get pillars, we go get good eat, we go get respect in the society.
Come on, down on the
way.
And they get 3 million total things the way they may look into that constitution.
Oh, how are
they? Then they try for getting the democracy in the country.
No.
As a country. Oh. If be a democracy.
Oh, not say for be one. No,
then they try for promote unity and coalition.
That now we all.
Yes. Fine. And then they try for promote reconciliation.
Oh,
this constitution not a one man business. And all man inside the committee, now 80 man committee. It
is
beyond political business.
So we said that it
representative.
Yes, Una, this. How are you now,
but let
the
village soon? Chief Fede,
how?
All man did it.
I go pass the lesson.
Now, all man did it. All man did it. All man did it. You say all day.
Now.
And this, now all man business.
How far is
that? Now, business, now in business, how we all business.
How are you now, but now?
We all for Sidon. And see that. All waiting in the put inside the constitution. No. We'll be able for
it. All right, let them be less sooner.
All right.
Let God make the intelligence, the sense part of
all right,
let them not make up our own.
All right.
Mr. Father, could you imagine?
All right, I don't say they can go because we're still doing it.
Let God be less sooner.
All right.
Hey, let God come on now, yeah?
All right. Talk go, talk come. Like you say, if we don't know how we come out, we don't go know how we go. So we pray, say we all go put hands together. But let we able to build this one green Mama Sabo. Thank you very much.
One party constitution due to people, but just as a survivor of his party, the APC, as a ruling party, introduced the now 1991 constitution, which we dubbed the multi-party constitution. Today we have here our own president. He is there because he subscribed to the adage that no people should give power to any government without first setting conditions for the use of that power. Our very own leader of the country, just as in the Magna Carta seal, it says, and I say this in Latin, Johannes per gratia Dei, Rex Anglia Dominus Hibernia. Just as John was, by the grace of God, King of England and Lord of Ireland, so is our own president, by the grace of God, who is here today to launch the CRC. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the indefatigable, the ever young and meticulous and active and enigmatic and active and dynamic president, His Excellency, President, inspired by Corona of Germany. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, Mr. Vice President, my lady, the Chief Justice, Ministers of Government, Honorable Members of Parliament, Members of the Diplomatic and Consular Corps, Leaders of political parties present here, the Mayor of Freetown and other Mayors and Chairmen, our religious leaders, paramount chiefs, tribal heads, and village heads, members of the civil society, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. We are gathered here today to launch the committee that will review the constitution of our dear country. This is a committee constituted from people of every region, political affiliation, and socio-economic group to perform this sacred responsibility. The Constitution is the supreme law of the land, and we must ensure that this document captures our better habits, our better values, and our better aspirations. We are amongst the most religiously tolerant of nations. Let the tolerance be expanded upon and deepen in our view. We are a nation of diverse ethnic groups, but we share common cuisines, religions, secret societies, surnames, and many more. Let that unity in diversity be reflected in the inclusiveness of our constitution. We are a friendly people. Let the Constitution be people friendly, easy to understand, and easy to follow. Let it be a Constitution that follows the wise dictum: do not command that which you cannot enforce. We are a nation that draws great strength from a noble pact amongst Africans, Europeans, and Americans to end slavery and spread freedom, enterprise, and eternal values. Our Constitution must reflect these foundational ideals of this realm of the free. We are a nation that have seen the evils of war, a people that have tested the bitterness of a violent conflict and suffered the deprivations of possible displacements and banishments. We must ensure a constitution that protects us from the causes and practices of these humiliations. Fellow Sierra Leoneans, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, our country has the deepest tradition of written constitutionalism in West Africa, starting with the constitution fashioned by Granville Shafi for the freedmen and women of the province of freedom, to the Black Hall Constitution of 1863, the Slater Constitution of 1924, and the Stevenson Constitution of the 50s. We gained independence with a constitution modeled along the monarchy's Westminster model. We established a republican presidential system in 1971, a one-party constitution in 1978, and reverted to a multi-party system in 1991. We have had constitutions imposed from above with little regard for the opinion of the people. But we have also had constitutions that sought inputs and mandates from the people of this great nation. We have had constitutions that require ministers to be drawn from parliament. And we now have a constitution which does not allow the same person to be a minister and a parliamentarian. We have had systems of government from the settlement of Granville Town to the independent kingdoms of the hinterland that were constituted by representatives of the people, or that we are in accord with the customs and traditions of our people. We have gone full circle with electoral systems, starting from the elections of comrades to indirect suffrage to first past the post system, the national proportional list system, the district block system, and once again, for the first past the post system. We have had models in which the head of government was elected by parliament, the one in which the people directly elect the president. We have had and rejected spells of military dictatorships. But we have also, for the most part of our history, rightly subjected the military to civilian oversight and control. Our governance and constitutional history gives us a library of lessons to draw from. In it, we can find a veritable storehouse of good governance practices and also aspirations for a better covenant between the people and the government. But we must also note that our constitutional history has its low points of compromising statutes, acrimonious debates, and democratic deficits. We must strive to assert the better moments of this history and avoid a repeat of acrimony, imposition, and despotism. Constitutions, they say, must stand the test of time. I strongly believe in this imperative, and I pray that the constitution we may fashion through this process is more enduring. But I also equally acknowledge that our Constitution, like every creation worthy of its existence, makes provision for its own renewal. Our Constitution makes that provision for renewal in section 108. By launching this constitutional review committee, we are obeying this great constitutional mandate to renew the Constitution. This is a nation that is renewing itself. This is a nation buoyant with energy, with youth, and with noble but humane aspirations. It is but fitting that our most fundamental of documents captures this renewal, that it reflects this dynamism, and that it is open up to the possibilities of a nation that aspires to have a developmental state, a democratic society, and a tolerant culture. We committed ourselves at the end of the war in the Lome Peace Agreement to fundamentally review the Constitution, and our Parliament itself, by enacting the agreement into law, reaffirms the mandate for a review. The Truth and Reconciliation Commission called upon us to do it. The Sierra Leone Conference on Development and Transformation urged us to align our fundamental laws with our aspirations to become a middle-income country and a donor nation. Women are advocating for the review of the 1991 Constitution to ensure that we do not have a constitution that protects and promotes their rights with one hand and then draws back this protection in other clauses. Youths and the physically challenged are demanding greater inclusion within government processes. And we have many governance reform and aspirations, from decentralization to gender equity, that are not properly anchored in the Constitution. These are the imperatives that propel the review. They are the reasons for the establishment of the committee, and we urge this committee to be true to the better aspirations of our people. Fellow Sierra Leoneans, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I took an oath on becoming president to uphold the Constitution. Today, I once again recommit my government to honor, respect, and uphold to the letter the spirit of the Constitution in section 108 that provides for the alteration of this Constitution. This review shall be true to the process prescribed in the Constitution for its alteration. The committee will submit its recommendation to my government. The government will look into the report and submit it to Parliament. If Parliament approves, it will then put it into a referendum for the people to decide the fate of the proposed covenant. All of us must also ensure that this process meets best international practice of modern constitutionalism. That is the only way we can become a truly modern nation, a nation at peace with itself and the global community, and a nation that can be counted amongst the best governed societies in the world. That is why I call upon you to align our constitution with the basic elements of modern constitutionalism, supremacy of the constitution, the rule of law, respect for human rights, separation of powers, checks and balances, independence of the judiciary, judicial review, equality before the law, civilian oversight of the military civilian authority, free and fair elections. We also charged this committee to look into earlier constitutions of our country, the report of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission, the report of the Synodal Conference on Transformation and Development, and the report of the Itatoka Constitutional Review Commission, which was established in 2006, that submitted its findings to government in 2008. Fellow Sierra Leoneans, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, when Granville Sharp wrote the constitution for the province of freedom, he derived his inspiration from Jethro's words unto Moses in Exodus 18:21, that government must be constituted. That government must be constituted from amongst persons who are able, persons who fear God, and persons of truth who hate covetousness. Islamic traditions also call for governance to be based on a surah of wise counselors that respect the authority. That respect majority opinion, protect the vulnerable, and uphold justice. These are ideals must be evident in our supreme document. They must be evident in those called upon to serve. They must be evident in the deliberations of the Constitutional Review Committee. We trust that this committee will not seek to impose its opinion on the people. We expect the Constitutional Review Committee to host public consultations in ways that allow every citizen to make a contribution. These consultations must not be centered within one specific area or region, but should span the length and breadth of Sierra Leone. The committee should also take advantage of other technological developments and receive submissions electronically to encourage the widest possible public participation. We also urge all Sierra Leoneans from every region, every district, ethnic group, and political and religious affiliations to support the process, fully participate in it, and take ownership of the review. This is the best way to make the resulting document a true covenant amongst all of us to honor our common aspirations. Good constitutions are not imposed. Democratic constitutions are continental. They are joining pacts amongst citizens to constitute themselves into a polity that they will love and honor, and whose interests they put above all else. That is why it is a great import that this process be all embracing and inclusive. That is why it is important that everybody should have a dignified and equitable place in this power map of the nation. That is why we must have a supreme document through which we can answer some of the most pressing challenges since the founding of this nation. Since the enactment of the 1991 Constitution, a number of issues have arisen relating to certain of its sections and provisions. I urge this committee to pay attention to these sections. We must act to remove constitutional ambiguities, ensure greater clarity of our statutes, and rationalize our governance processes. I believe that this process will yield a worthy outcome. I believe that this nation is capable of coming up with a constitutional model that will ensure inclusive, accountable, and developmental governance. We shall rise up to the challenge. We shall ensure a fundamental document that democratically guides the renewal of this nation. And we must make this movement worthy of the best instances of our history and the better aspirations of the people of this country, so that our children and grandchildren shall refer to this moment as they give voice to the immortal words of our anthem, "Realm of the Free, Family United, Land that we love, our Sierra Leone." It is now my honor to launch the constitutional review process. God bless Sierra Leone.
Who are familiar with the Bible? Romans 20, verses 1 to 4, tells us about our comportment and relationship with our leaders. See, you must respect the constituted authority on earth, before they are the representative of God among you. And I know why President Nkrumah, today I know why, is our president. Let us look at his education, which he has just given us an overview of now here. You will know that he studied politics, he studied history, and he studied economics. That is from the islands of West Africa, for a big college. To be called an Oxford Don in the days of yore, you have to study what they call the PPE, the politics, the philosophy, and the economics. So President Nkrumah has demonstrated that he has a very well-rounded education, which encompasses the education itself, culture, religion, and humanity. Mr. President, I am really enthused by your speech this morning, and I believe that you are one of those presidents who is accountable to his people. Your Excellency, we thank you for that great delivery, and I hope that I'll get a copy of that, so that I can learn some more of my history, where you started. I didn't even know that our constitution started with Granville Sharp in the 1800s. And then it came on to Slater and Stevenson. Now look at this, then Samuel T. McGann and Sir Albert McGann and Dr. Shaka Provin Stevens, and latterly, unforgettable accomplishments in rock. May I inform participants that when you're going out, there will be a cup for free distribution. It is now my pleasure to call on to the secretary of the CRC to give us the vote of thanks. Give him a big hand, please.
Excellency, the President of the Republic of Sierra Leone, the Honorable Vice President, Cabinet Ministers, led by the Special Representative of the Secretary General, members of the high table, all other protocols observed. I once attended a function where one of the participants was requested to give the vote of thanks. The gentleman rose from his seat, mounted the podium, and said, "I thank all the participants who participated in this participation." And that, of course, provoked laughter, and that was the end of the vote of thanks. I will deviate from that sort of approach, taking into account the auspicious nature of a moment occasion like this, and the imperative that has been emphasized by various speakers. And so my vote of thanks will first identify the key actors who have made it happen so that it can be recognized and acknowledged. And then I will also assure the beneficiaries, that is all of us here, that their interests will not be compromised by this august body that has been constituted. Mr. Chairman, some 1,000 years ago, the Roman Emperor Augustus Emerius set up a body similar to the Constitutional Review Commission to advise him on how to run his empire. And this was the advice he gave them, and I quote, "Do what comes to hand with correct and natural dignity, with humility, independence, and justice, and allow your minds freedom from all other considerations." Unquote. His Excellency has given his speech to members of the committee. And therefore, it behoves on the committee that we should challenge the process, we should inspire a shared vision among Sierra Leoneans, and we should enable every Sierra Leonean to act, to be part of it, so that at the end of the day, the instrument we will come up with will reflect the aspirations of all of us. Therefore, the committee is the People's Committee, and as one speaker said, the government is merely leading the process. And so, since this process was initiated, we've been hearing a lot of reactions from the media, from cross-section of the society. We have had all of them, we have listened to some of them, we remember most of them. But I want to assure you that in all of this, we will do it with humility, independence, and justice, and will not be swayed by any other consideration. Therefore, I wish, on behalf of the committee, to first of all thank He from whom all blessings flow, that is the Almighty God. In His creation, He created a niche for us and called it Sierra Leone. We thank Him that He has been able to keep us together, and that we pray that He will continue to guide us so that as we come to the realization that we have to take our own destiny into our own hands, we will do so unfettered and with the inspiration that has been given to us this morning by the President. Also, those who drink water from the well should not forget those who dug the well. I'm sure we have heard that this country has had several constitutions and other instruments of governance. They did not happen by chance. They were formulated by individuals who took their time to use their God-given talents to put together instruments that will enable us to manage our affairs. And so we thank those people for their commitment, and we pray that the aspiration that they have for us will definitely not go in vain, and that at the end of the day, the paradise that we are looking for and that they have in mind, we'll be able to accomplish it. Now, to the present, I wish to thank the government led by His Excellency for ensuring that this process happens. Your Excellency, people have called you all types of names in this country, some genuinely, others are sycophants. But what I have discerned from your speech this morning is that you are a transformational leader, because you always speak your mind. And one of the qualities of a transformational leader is being truthful. And again, you are very futuristic in all your endeavors.
We do so with the mindset that we are not only looking after ourselves, but we are also looking after future generations. So thank you for that. To members of the Planning Committee, the Honorable Attorney General has this morning listed them: Ministry of Finance, Office of the Chief of Staff, Office of the Attorney General, etc., etc. These people have worked very hard since the pronouncement of His Excellency to make sure that the process is initiated, and today it is being anchored by His Excellency. I want to assure those people that their effort will not go in vain. So that when a retrospect is taken of this process, it will be said of them that never in the history of the transformation of Sierra Leone did so many owe so much to so few. So I thank you, and I hope we continue your support can reach the height of greatness. Unless in all fields, critical to it growth and creativity, there is ample supply of dedicated men and women. This is now the time for us to act decisively to regenerate the potential of our country, because on our back rests the coming of Sierra Leone tomorrow. I thank you very much.
They not each 10,000 leos, just in case somebody says 10,000 leos each. It's 10,000 leos jointly. Thank you very much.